One, two, three, action. Yo, it's the weekend. I don't know. There's nothing to say. Roll it. I don't know what it is with Abel bringing back Swedish House Mafia. Swedish House Mafia was like at, I don't know, at their prime. They were definitely up there as probably the biggest EDM group of that time, which was like 2009 timeframe, 2010 maybe. And that's when Abel had just released the trilogy, maybe like a year or two later. So I know he's got to be a fan. There's no way he's not a fan, especially if you're anyone in the EDM world. It was a big moment when Swedish House was alive and thriving. This is the second track off the new album with Swedish House Mafia. So I don't know if they're making a comeback. I don't know what their relationship is with The Weeknd. Is it going to be like a collaboration project that's coming out? No idea, but I'm here for it. Follow your boy, Instagram, Twitter, Discord. Most importantly, hit up the Twitch. We do this live. This video is literally being recorded live in front of 77 viewers at the present moment. So if y'all want to catch the videos live, if you want to see what it looks like when I record these things, get the behind the scenes, watch me record, then consider joining the Twitch. Second link in the description. If y'all guys want to support the channel, consider joining Patreon, which is the first link in the description. I couldn't think there for a second. If y'all guys want to get early access to videos, if y'all guys want to get exclusive reactions, just this week alone, I probably posted like 5 or 6 videos that are on Patreon that won't ever see YouTube. So if y'all guys want to get extra access and support the content and support me as a creator and keep me in front of the camera, consider joining over on Patreon. But other than that, there's not really too much to say. Let's get it. Hold on, before we even get into his fucking angelic voice. This kind of has the same vibe of the last video. Are we about to have like another storyline? Because obviously After Hours had an entire storyline. Don't even get me started on the fact we didn't get a fucking Faith video. I want to punch a hole in my wall right now just thinking about it. But I feel like this is going to have a storyline as well. It already seems darker. Knock 'em off. You need initially. It's already toxic as fuck, bro. Like a moth to a flame, I'm gonna pull you back into what you needed initially. But anybody that knows anybody knows that moths die whenever they go to a flame. They can't help it. They can't help but going to their death. Just like she can't help but going to Abel, you know? What you need initially. It's just one call away, and you'll leave him, you're loyal to me, but this time I'll let you be, 'cause he seems like he's good for you. Oh, he seems like he's good for you?
I'll make you know that you need me, but I'm gonna let you be because he seems like he's good for you, even though you want me.
You know what I'm saying, bro?
This has serious, like, After Hours and Kissland. If they had a baby, it would sound like this right here. Again, I still don't know what's going on with the video. I'm still freaked out by the video. We'll see. I have literally no idea where the video is going or the whole entire cinematic universe. I feel like it's like Matrix-y. 'Cause he seems like he's good for.
Your friends. But does he know you call me? Oh my god. He sleeps, fucking Swedish House is the goat. Alexo, Sebastian. I forgot the third one. God damn, bro. Where am I? Am I in 2010? What's the deal? This sounds like it's right off of their Until One album. The only album that they put out. Fuck what your friends are saying, bitch. And all your friends say he's the one. But fuck your friends. But does he know you call me when he sleeps? Fuck. I
I'm not going to be able to get past this part, guys. We might hear this 5 times before I move on. But does he know you call me when he says... The fucking piano, bro. This sounds like it's right off of their album. But does he know you call me when he says... All right, fuck it. One more time. Does he know you call me when he sleeps? Or does he know the pictures that you keep? Did he say, does he know the pain that you keep? Or does he know the pictures that you keep? I hear the secrets that you keep when you're talking in your sleep. Ooh, man, Swedish House Mafia, bro. Does he know the pictures that you keep? Or does he know the reasons that you cry? Or tell me, does he know where your heart lies? Does he know the reasons that you cry? And tell me, does he know that your heart lies? It literally could be your heart lies with me, or it literally could be your heart lies to keep you in that relationship. Like, you're not as happy as you could be if you were with me. I'm watching you from afar in this relationship, and I know that you're still mine deep down. He don't know where your heart truly lies, bro. He don't know that your heart lies with me. Yeah, you should be with him. I let you go from time. You should stay with him, cause he seems like he's good for you. Ooh. And he makes you feel like you should. And all your friends say he's the one. His love for does he know you call me when he sleeps? I don't even know who's better on this song right now. Is Swedish House production better? Or is The Weeknd better? And I don't know what the fuck's happening in the video. Is everybody tied to him? All of his different like relationships he's had in the past? And I'm getting super creeped out Blade vibes right now. So good. It's so Swedish House Mafia. Now I kind of wish that The Weeknd was popping when they made their album. If I get an entire album right now of Swedish House Mafia and The Weeknd, if Until Dawn is both of them together, the entire album, I'm liable to lose my shit. And I'm talking about like take a shit and then don't remember where it's at. That's how much I'm gonna lose my shit. Like, oh damn, I shit outside, but I don't remember where it's at. Lost my shit. Right here with me. I told you, where it truly lies is right here with me. Does he know that? He doesn't know that. This is almost like that one song, the sad song off of the slow one, off of After Hours. Scared to Live. That's the track. Yep. That's basically Scared to Live is him telling her to move on. And this song is basically saying like, I know why you can't move on. And you can't move on because I'm me. Right here with me. Truly lies, my baby, where it truly lies. This is a fucking goat picture right here. Why does The Weeknd, why is he sitting there like that, like he's Jabba the Hutt? Truly lies.
comes. Oh my God. Put it in reverse, Ted.
The offbeat, not the offbeat, they're technically on beat, but like on the upbeat piano notes. That is so Swedish House Mafia instead of on the downbeat. Bro, this is too fucking good. Oh, Swedish House is gonna go ham if I get the whole album. Guys, I misplaced my shit. Do you remember where it was? That music video is scary as fuck. If anybody watches Corridor Digital, there is a main thing when it comes to VFX in movies and CGI. Your brain is so in tune to knowing what a human looks like that it's called the uncanny valley, where like you can't quite put your finger on it on why it doesn't look right, but you know that it doesn't look right. That's what I'm getting from this video, like with all the people in here. Like something about these people doesn't look right. It's just enough to be unsettling. There's the sun bringing the dawn. Yo, I swear to God, we better get a combination album of Swedish House and The Weeknd. That song is, it might not be a 10, realistically, amongst Abel's entire discography. But it is a 10 though, because I'm hyped as fuck. Mainly, it's a 10 because of Swedish House Mafia collaboing with The Weeknd, and it's about as perfect as a collab as you can ask for from The Weeknd. The vibe of his music very much fits the vibe of Swedish House's music. Swedish House's music is kind of like, it's not the hardest EDM. Like, you're not going to get a crazy drop. We didn't get a single crazy drop in this video, but it's just enough to be like, damn, that's satisfying. And his voice just fits perfect on the style of instrumentation that they make, or the style of music that they make. Crazy, bro. Oh my God. Wild. I don't know what else there is to say.